Greetings, friends of typography. Typography Weekly is a community-driven newsletter where we highlight the most noteworthy typography news and links of the last week or weeks. With this video, I'm trying out a new format based on it. Typography Monthly, where I feature a few Typography Weekly entries of the last month and comment on it, provide background information and so on. Feel free to let me know in the comments if you like this new format and if you want to see more episodes of it in the future. You probably heard about the Sans Forgetica font 2 years ago. It was all over the news. A font which promises that you remember what you read better just because the text is set in this font. Sounds too good to be true, doesn't it? This project was based on scientific studies which suggested that sometimes people can remember the content of a text better when the font is harder to read. And a team of designers and scientists at the Australian RMIT University then created Sans Forgetica, which was specifically designed to create this effect. Now another team of scientists led by the University of Waikato, New Zealand, tried to replicate the results in a study with a series of tests involving over 800 participants. But the study published in the journal Memory could not find that Sans Forgetica improves memory performance in any way. For many professionals in the field of typography, this comes as no surprise. If you read a text more slowly and focused, then of course you can more easily remember the content. But trying to enforce that for an entire text by using a font with a poor legibility is a bad idea. It's up to the reader to read more carefully, and the reader can even adjust the reading speed and the focus based on the specific passage of a text. Poor legibility over an entire text will only frustrate readers and might make them stop reading the text altogether. If you want to get all the details about the new study, a link to the paper is in the description. Apple has recently licensed fonts from type foundry such as Commercial Type and Klim Type Foundry to be used as system fonts on Mac OS Catalina. But since these fonts are an optional download, many users of Mac OS X are not even aware they have access to them for free. To see and install these optional fonts, open the Fontbook application and switch to All Fonts. Browse the font list and you will see lots of font families that are grayed out, either because they were deactivated or they weren't downloaded yet. If you right-click on a font or font family that wasn't downloaded yet, you see an option to download the individual font or the entire family. And here you can see some highlights. To see a complete list of all available fonts, check out the link to the support document from Apple in the description of this video. Monotype continues its strategy of growth by acquisition. Here's a list of brands that Monotype has bought over the years. Now it also acquired the German type foundry URW, based in Hamburg. If you haven't heard of URW, they are one of the biggest digital type foundries in Germany and they were also one of the first ones. With their Icarus system, they were a pioneer in font digitization. Mind you, in the 1970s, long before there was desktop publishing. URW sold hard and software solutions and had a growing type library. Around 1990, the company had around 250 employees and offices around the world. But with the growing success of Macs and PCs, the company went bankrupt in 1995. The work continued as URW++ with a focus on the Type Foundry business. after the foundry was already sold to the British company Global Graphics in 2015, it is now being acquired by Monotype. And that means that with Linotype, Fontshop, the FontFont library and now URW, Monotype has now taken over all major digital foundries and font online shops in Germany. And that's it for the first episode of Typography Monthly.